Richard Riley. So, Jeff kicked off the session with a demo of some of the great social and sharing enhancements that we've made to SharePoint. And I'm going to spend the next few minutes walking through some of the cool new enterprise features. Specifically, we're going to take a look at search, web publishing, and enterprise content management. And we're going to start off with search. Now, the search folks have been extremely busy over the past 3 years. Unifying the FAST and SharePoint cores, we now have a single search engine in SharePoint 2013. And then they've built an intuitive, personal, and actionable interface on top of that. So to give you an example of where that starts, it really starts at the query box. I've just typed in a query for marketing. You can see we get the normal kind of type ahead capabilities that you're all probably familiar with. But at the bottom, we get these blue links. Now what these are called are personal refined links. So how many times have you searched for something and then gone back and searched for it a bunch of times more because you couldn't remember or you needed to go find it again? These links direct you straight back to the result that you found the first time without having to go through the results page. So they save a ton of time. And I'm telling you, they are super useful when you keep forgetting stuff and you need to go back into search and find that thing that you just lost. So let me give you a quick tour of what we've done here. We've completely revamped the look and feel. We've got visual refiners out of the box on the left-hand side. We also have the cover card that you saw Jeff talk about earlier. Now these things show up in a lot of places across SharePoint. But what search does is something quite special. When the indexer goes and indexes the content, in this case it's a PowerPoint, it actually looks inside the document and picks out areas of the content that it thinks are going to be important, like paragraph headings or slide titles, and it adds them as deep links into the hover card. So right from the results page here, I can click through, for example, onto Making Choices, which is a slide right within that deck, and I've gone from search to click to the exact slide that I wanted in literally 3 clicks, and this is a pretty cool capability, I think, that we've added into the search. Now the last thing on the search page that I want to show you is this area at the top. And this is called a results block. And what we're doing here is trying to be smart with the query that people put in and actually trying to understand it. So I've done a search for marketing deck. And behind the scenes we have a set of query rules. And what these do is they translate the English that you put in or the language that you put in into something that the search engine understands a little bit more. So in this case, it's bringing back results that don't include marketing and the words marketing and the words deck. It's bringing back PowerPoint, because it understands deck means PowerPoint. This thing machine learns as well, and it can prioritize different rules. You can add your own rules. You can use the query logs to add new rules. And it makes it really easy to create a very personal experience, and a very relevant experience to your end users using these query rules.